I advise a lot of corporations about safety and security. And one of the most illuminating stories came after a conversation with a CEO of a very well-known company. I asked him, how often do you meet your chief financial officer? And he said, oh, about twice a week at the minimum. And I said, how about your COO? And he said, at least once a day, if not more. And I said, how about your chief security officer? And he kind of waved me off and he goes, oh, he's former FBI. I know he knows what he's doing. That's a scary phenomenon. A CEO or a leader of a corporation needs to understand safety and security. You need to own it. The best crisis management leaders are those who live by an important assumption. They assume the boom. What do I mean by that? I know assumptions are sometimes bad, but great leaders imagine and own the worst case scenario. So it's important to anticipate that boom, whatever it could be, a hurricane, a fire, an active shooter, a terror attack, whatever it may be, it is important to anticipate the event. But first, if you want to know about crisis leadership, it is important to know what a crisis actually is. It isn't a mere problem that you may have, you know, something's not working, the budget doesn't look right, right? It's also not an emergency, say a fire, right? Or the phone's going out. Those you've probably anticipated and you know what to do. A crisis is really a situation where the standard operating procedures fail. And why is that? First, because the event, the boom, right, threatens a high priority value of your organization. Second, it presents a restricted amount of time in which a response can be made. You simply can't deal with this next month. And finally, the event itself is unexpected or unanticipated by you or the organization. So the best you can do is anticipate it and then do as much as you can to prepare for it. So how best can you prepare for it? The first is rather mundane. Practice, practice, practice. You know those drills you sometimes ignore or those tabletop exercises that you've always been meaning to get to? Get to them. Because it's not just about you as a leader. It's about your team understanding that you take this seriously. Make sure that your systems are protected, whether it's in cybersecurity or physical security or both. You want to ensure that you don't have any gaps that could harm your organization. Finally, educate yourself and your team on what will happen if that day comes. Don't assume everyone knows what to do. Communicate, communicate, and communicate. Look, you cannot stop all bad things from happening. You have to assume the boom, and then you have to own it.